Steve, this is the telescope that you have packed for me.
Yes.
Okay, can I see it? Meade Astronomical Telescope. It came all the way from the America, huh?
It did, yes.
Oh, lovely. Look at that. That's the foam proper material. Oh, the glorious baby. Amazing. It is beautiful. Oh yeah, how many years of joy. Yeah. Thank you very much for opening, boxing it for me. And I will take the box with me home, showing it to my lady. Let me see. Thank you very much.
No, it's my pleasure.
Yeah. You actually are working in Spain and making the observatory there.
So that's what we're having built.
Oh, lovely. So, ENS Optical is now in Spain and building observatory, like the one that I saw actually today or so. In South Africa, the roof moves like that.
Yeah.
That's the same design, I think.
I've been at this 6 months now, getting it to this stage.
So oh, lovely.
Time's kind of split a little bit.
Oh.
I've never been videoed in my life.
That's all right. This is for a video in the YouTube channel. I have a YouTube channel, so it goes there. If you don't want, I will not put it there. Yeah, it's an interesting place. Look, full of the optical systems in there.
If you want to see what's interesting,
yes, please. Can we see?
It's a haberdashery of
destruction.
Yes, at the moment I'm in a rock nest, so shot everywhere.
Oh, look at this big telescope, Celestrons, all Celestrons. 20, oh, 2-inch diagonals.
So, as you can see, we're having while I'm having the decorators in.
Oh, that's the baby I know from the glass.
Yes.
That's the baby I'm getting.
It is, yes.
Oh, lovely.
So, there you go. I've just set it up. I've got two of them I'm setting up today.
Oh.
There's yours, and there's that one going to Serbia this afternoon.
Oh, what is that? Is it the EMX? Same. Oh, the same?
Yeah, that one's going to Serbia.
Oh, lovely. Do you have a right angle that can attach to this?
I do, as it happens.
Oh, just asking.
I do. So there's that. Here's the warehouse.
How much does it cost me?
I don't know. It's on the side over there. I'll show you.
Oh, lovely.
Now there's this.
Oh, look at that. Optician's dreamland. Chocolate factory. Ah.
So I've got lots of stuff.
Yes, yes. I'm after one of those butter semi-apochromatic filters. I've got a Skywatcher 102. It's a Skytravel. They have a really crappy aberration. But the wide view of that telescope is amazing. So I just want to see if I can correct it.
So, and there's telescopes.
Oof.
Also, yeah, and all around the corner and everywhere.
But, do we have a box for my telescope?
No, I have one box, and unfortunately, that's the one that's got to go to Serbia.
Oh, can I have another if you have any...
If I had a box...
Or one of these kind of carrying thingies. Carrying boxes.
We'll have a look in a minute.
Buyers should have a priority, kind of.
In my case, the man who bought it first has the priority, and it was the man in Serbia.
Oh.
So there's tons of stuff in here.
Okay, lovely. Look at that. Maybe I have a 10-inch in my car, actually.
You have a 10-inch scope?
Dobsonian, yeah. It's one of those, what is collapsible ones? Flex tube.
Yeah, trust you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm building a shed for that, so just putting it in a shed.
So, yes, once it's all
lovely.
Done.
Lovely. Babies, it's good to bring the kids here to play. Do you have a box that I can put the thing on it?
Don't know yet, I'll have a look at
Yes, please. Bless you.
We'll get it tested, show you what it does,
yes.
Show you how it goes.
Yes.
And then we'll take it from there. I've already set it up so the align north works.
Yes.
So I've turned it on earlier. So what it does is it works a bit like an aisle, Derek. It moves up and down.
Yes.
And there's a little ball bearing bearing in here.
Yes.
And from that, the ball bearing goes in a certain spot when it's level.
Oh.
It then has a magnet in it.
Yes.
So it spins around till it finds north.
Oh.
And then once it's done that, because you've already put the time, etc. Yeah. into it, it then works.
So it doesn't have a GPS. We have to manually put it. That's gimmicks, I know. You have to do it.
I don't use, I mean, I've got 11 telescopes in Spain, and I don't use GPS.
Yeah,
GPS is a sales gimmick by companies to get you to upgrade from the previous model
to the next one.
It's a bit like buying a Ford Focus LX. But next year's Ford Focus, it's the LXI. Yeah. It's ridiculous, but still.
Can I attach my, I got a click lock, but a click lock thing.
Yeah,
and goes here, just 2 inch. I want to use 2 inch on this. I may go to other telescopes, this other one. Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah, everything. Lovely.
Best upgrade you can do is you put a feather touch.
Yeah, that's what I want to actually do, a motor or something for this, or feather touch.
Feather touch.
How much that will cost me?
You pay about 300 quid for them, so I should wait till you get it up and working first.
Yes.
So, but yes, no.
Let's just see the... So, can I see the optics?
Yeah, of course you can. I haven't even looked at them myself, yes.
Yeah. Lovely.
I'll give them a blow in a second if you want.
Oh, is it possible? You have a blower, huh?
Of course I have. I've been optics all day long.
Really just today I saw that somebody was washing it in South Africa.
I'm just going to get the excess off.
Yes.
And then I'll give it a proper clay. It's a bit cold in here.
Yeah. That's lovely. Does it need a dew shield also?
I have those if need be.
Yeah, or I can make one from this. They say that from
the
foam.
Well, make it out of a bit of foam, which is what I do. People are very prissy these days with the telescopes. They have to be perfect.
Yeah.
But to be fair, most telescopes we use in the dark.
Yeah,
you
know.
Can't see them. So a dew shield's job is to stop dew getting on your glass, doesn't
it? I have exactly those things, I have also carbon thingy that you can actually clean it without any... Yeah. That's how I use it for cameras, so I just can use it.
Yeah, so do I. It's a bit cold in here at the moment.
Yeah. Beautiful. So that's how you clean your telescope.
Normally I would have brought it downstairs and put it into a warmer room, because at the moment the optics are far too cold to clean. So when you get them home, just blow them off like that, bit of breath, clean cloth, and then just gently do that. And any I'll have left just one or two tiny smears on, and just take them off. See, like there.
Oh.
But it's because it's too cold.
Yes.
So,
what's the effect of being too cold? Oh, I just want to know. If it is too cold, what happens? Okay, you have a vapor in it. Yeah. That's it. That's actually good because you can clean it. It causes a little bit less friction. Any particles?
One of the best cleaning things that you'll ever have is your own breath.
Yeah.
So, and if it's freezing cold, all you'd be doing is wiping the vapor around.
Yes. Hmm. Let's move it, huh? Just to see how it goes up and down.
I've just altered the speed to maximum there.
Yes.
You can go down so it
drains the battery.
It's trying to center. Let's just press center.
And how it moves in the azimuth, as you move. Oh, lovely. Brilliant. That's true. Where is the battery? Is it there? Oh, here.
I've got it ringing up.
Oh, you're attached to your own power supply. Oh, okay. Now, just last night I was reading about this. This one of the CCD auto guiders. Does it have a port for that or no? I cannot.
No, you can buy a 909. It's called a hash 909 adapter, which is a special adapter that. Okay, because I've messed with it. It failed, but that's okay.
Yeah. how it can be a finder.
To be honest with you, as a finder, it's the worst finder in the world. and I'll be honest, it's a joke.
Yeah.
Use that. Or yeah. Do what I do. Best bit of advice I can give you as far as finders go is do what I do, take that off, and put a Telrad on.
Oh, yeah.
If you don't know what, have you ever seen a Telrad?
I read about it, Telrad, but I've not seen it.
Telrad.
Oh, okay.
Ugliest finder in the world.
Yeah, how it works, I always wondered.
Basically, it projects a bullseye on there.
Yeah.
And so you get zero magnification, but in the night sky you can see exactly where you're looking.
Yes.
I haven't got one with batteries in it, so look at them.
How much are they?
Oh, they're about £40.
Oh. Yeah.
But they're really ugly.
Yeah. How are you attached to a cable tie?
Double sided tape.
Oh, okay.
They're really ugly, but they're really, really, really good.
Yeah.
It's what I use. Yeah.
Can I have one of these?
Yeah, I've got one without stuff on that. You just need to put a bit of double sided tape on.
Impressive.
So what you're asking me for is that?
Oh yes, I wanted because I've got a Omni, Celestron Omni 127, and I want to use one of these for that. But it should have a bracket because that one has a bracket. Does it have a bracket?
The Omni has a different bracket. The Omni takes that type of bracket.
Okay, so how much is this one?
Off the top of my head, £40-£50.
Okay, can I have this one?
Then the other thing you're perhaps looking at is.
This. Oh, what is that? A focal.
No, it's an illuminator.
Illuminator, oh. Are you giving it to me?
No, I was showing you because you asked me about one when you first came in.
Yeah.
Remember?
Yeah, for this.
That's the best finder Meade ever made. It's bigger than normal.
Yeah.
It's 9x60.
Yeah.
And if you look, have a look through it.
I'll look through it first.
I'd have to work it out for you.
Yeah.
But it depends if you want the right-angled one or not. I'm busy. I personally would use a Telrad.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, I will go with that one until I'm a little bit knowledgeable more. But I like this design also. It looks more gimmicky.
It's a much better finder, to be honest, but it's not as good, in my opinion, as the 40 quid Telrad.
Really?
So
That's
probably £100.
Oh.
Whereas that's 40.
40.
And to be honest, it's better.
So where it goes, where I put the tail rod?
Here? What I would do, if it was me, was...
I mean, I want to have this. I just want to add the tail rod, just in the case.
Well, you can put it there if you want a lot of people. Or, when you take this off, you can put it there.
Oh, just in front of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's lovely. So that definitely goes with the Omni. Do you have an Omni? That's
the question. It's the Max Utoff, isn't it?
Yeah, no, it's a Schmidt Cassegrain. I'll show you. Can you explain for our viewers why we should not use this one, which comes with the telescope, actually?
Well, the biggest problem with this is it's a gimmick to help show you the telescope when you're being sold the telescope. If you look, it's really flimsy.
Very wobbly. Yeah.
And the biggest problem is... We tend to use telescopes in the dark.
Yes.
And when you're in the dark, you wear coats because it's cold and gloves and other things. And what happens is you catch it.
Oh, God.
So what you do is you take that off, you remove it, you put some Velcro on the back, and you go, boom.
Yeah, that's
and you've
it.
Got nowhere
to catch it. You can put here, you can put this side.
You can put any side you want. Uh-huh. And a lot of people actually put them on top of the tube. Because generally, your tube's facing up
anyway. Yes, that's safe, actually. It's not on the way, even.
So,
lovely.
But this is a... a wonderful thing for me to show you a telescope.
Yes.
But in the demonstration. Field, in the field, not so good.
Yeah. And we also changed the actual viewfinder of that. We made a deal on that.
Yes.
So this one, which was the original 851,
well, this,
we changed it for the right angle, bigger one.
This is an original viewfinder that hasn't been made for, let me think, late 80s.
Oh.
It was the late 80s, early 90s. This is what's called a Meade Polaris finder.
Yes.
It's 9 by 60, so slightly more magnification and 10 mil aperture. And out of all the finders Meade have ever made, that's the best.
Yes. And what is this doing?
It's an illuminator. You just...
And does it need a battery?
It will more than likely need a battery.
And this is the inside here, huh?
There's the inside, yeah. Okay. You just go in there, turn it on, job done.
It's lovely. Thank you very much. Yeah, brilliant. Let's go for the tail rod, because I have also another thing. And I know that I have Dobsonian, and I probably get the tail rod now that I'm here.
I will find
I know in the eBay the tail rods can be selling for any price. So
Yeah.
One you give me now probably is better.
So, and I tend to use, if you're a scientist, the tape that I use for astronomy is VHB tape.
Yes, oh, okay.
So rather than just normal double-sided tape, it's great in your home.
Yes.
But when it's cold or hot, so if you're doing solar or if you're doing nighttime work where it's -5, it doesn't keep its bond. So VHB stands for very high bond.
That's great. Thank you.
You just use VHB tape.
So do you have VHB tape also?
Matt. Is a cheap version of VHB VHB tape,
okay.
But this is something I use for something else, but
yes.
It's very sticky. But
yeah.
VHB tape's generally made by good manufacturers like 3M.
Oh.
And it will say in the title VHB, and you're going to want, for most astronomy uses, 12, 15 mil wide roll. You'll pay about 20 quid for a roll. In fact, when we're off camera, there's a new mate that I've been using for the last month, and I bought it off Amazon. I can't remember the make off the top of my head, but it's a type of VHB tape. It's 20 quid a roll, but it's brilliant. And I'll give you the link to that.
That's great. What's the use of it exactly? Can you explain for the viewers what you do with that?
Well, that sticks on there.
Uh-huh. The other side of it is also sticky.
The other side is also sticky.
Your tail rod goes on that.
And your tail rod goes on that. This isn't good enough for that because it's not thick enough and there's no foam in there.
Yes.
But VHB is proper double sided.
Thank you. We have a tail rod. You look through here. So the rest of it, which is this compartment, it's mostly empty actually.
Yeah. But if you look, it's basically a battery compartment with two batteries held in place.
Yes.
And then it's an illuminator back here,
which
illuminates onto.
Oh, that's a little mirror.
There. Yeah. And then the mirror reflects up onto there.
Oh, okay.
It's.
So how you see the sky? Sky is seen through here.
So it's from that side.
Ah.
You see, a tail red's quite an unusual finder. It's really ugly.
What's the difference between those and those red dot ones?
This works and they're crap.
Oh!
Red dot finders, inherently, okay, if I was to look at, try and focus on a star in the night sky, although it's a very bright object, it's also a million, millions and millions of miles away, so it's a light point source.
Yes.
If you use a point light source of a red dot, generally trying to line up, even as dull as you dull that down, it affects your night vision and you can't actually see the star properly.
Yes.
This has no centre. It's a bullseye. Outer ring, inner ring, nothing in the centre. Mm-hmm. And each ring is 5 degrees apart, so it allows you to star hop and find things.
And where are those rings, actually? They're inside on that mirror.
They're projected.
Projected from here.
Projected from there onto the mirror up to there.
Oh, that's great. Beautiful. So, I'm getting this one also. Yeah.
I'll put that there.
But that goes probably with my Dobsonian telescope.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Doesn't fall, huh?
Pardon?
Doesn't fall. Doesn't fall.
It will if I hit it with the moment. I'm just putting it there so it's all together.
Yes,
it's not going to fall at the moment.
Yes, yes. Thank you.
No, it's okay. My pleasure. So basically, a plastic shield that you shove over the front of the scope.
Yes.
Because you're at that angle and it helps to deflect any dew that's in the air falling on the front of it.
Yes.
That's great. It does a brilliant job. But we live in the UK.
Yeah.
And the UK gets more dew than most of the countries in the world. Yeah. So what you do is you put the same thing on, it looks exactly the same, mm-hmm. apart from it's got a heater band built in here.
Oh.
So, and then that plugs into the dew heater.
Yo, lovely. And the dew heater, this kind of connector,
yeah.
goes to the
connector. If you follow me around here, I'll show you a myriad of different dew controllers.
Oh.
Basically, that plugs into there, and you use that to decide how much heat you're yeah. going to put through that.
Okay, it doesn't go on the actual telescope no. itself, or my...
Yeah, this is the only problem with buying one with a heater.
Oh.
In order to use the heater, you have to then buy one of those.
Okay, how much is that?
I'll come back to that in a minute.
Yes,
but
off the camera.
You don't need it... No, you don't need it straight away.
Yeah.
You could get away with the normal one.
Yeah.
But in the end... As we're in the UK, I will tell you 110,000% you will need a dew heater
yes.
in the end. You don't need one to start with.
Yes.
You can get up and running.
Yes.
You can enjoy the scope.
Yes.
But dew is your biggest problem in the UK.
Yes, definitely.
So you will end up buying one.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I know that. How it is every day dealing with the frost also. About this, okay?
Yeah.
So now, in a later date, I just changed my mind. I wanted to have a... your heater for this.
So what you do is you buy one of these and then that.
Oh, it goes around it.
Around like that. So it does the same job as the other one, other one I showed you, just with two different parts.
And what's the brand of that you showed me? The
this
plastic?
One's a Kendrick.
Kendrick, oh, also. Yeah, I see here. Mm-hmm. Kendrick Astro Instruments.
Canadian.
Fairly made in China. Good.
Yep, probably made in Canada.
Yeah.
But actually, I've opened one, maybe not.
Can be used for the head also, headband, as a headband.
Yeah, if you want to look at John McEnroe, or be on the board.
That's nice.
So, there you go. And then that, if you follow me, goes...
Oh, that looks really nice. Goes with that even, makes it more beautiful. Yeah.
So
how much is this with this now?
Oh, I haven't got a clue off the top.
Okay, you have to tell me.
That's why I should take it off.
Yeah. This is the Meade LX90 that I have bought. As you can see, it's a bit lighter than the LX200, which is a kind of stronger, heavier fork mount, which you can see here. And with this one, you can actually put it an equatorial wedge on this and just do long exposure astrophotography. Of course, with the Registax, you don't need really much of that if you're just doing casual astrophotography. Registax will do with 15-30 second exposures. Good job for you if you want. So you told me whenever I want to move the telescope...
Whenever you move a telescope, or you've got to put it away, don't be tempted just to move it and do everything with everything assembled.
Yes.
You always disassemble.
Yeah.
Always, because it's very easy to break things like this.
Oh, that's a little glass. Yeah. Plastic.
So, leave this on, though,
yeah.
and I'll show you why. So we'll take that off. I'll pull that off, and they always fall off. When you've finished this, you undo that clutch.
Oh, goes down.
So it's much smaller.
Yeah,
push that
takes less
here.
Space. It's almost the size of that Dobsonian I have.
Exactly, it's quite compact. That's what, it's, and what you do then, you can carry it on your back seat.
Yeah.
Job done.
Okay, how you open it then? It's not...
There's a knack to that.
So what about this wire? Is not on the way?
No, or you can just do that.
Oh, okay. So...
So, whenever you take it down, remember this isn't cheap. So you
yes.
always keep a hold on it.
Yes.
You undo that knob, but you always keep a hold on it. Because you see a lot of Meade telescopes broken online.
Yeah, I've seen
them. People... who stand there doing this.
Yeah.
And then what happens is the scope goes.
And the fall.
And you'll know when it's undone.
That.
just check. There you go.
And how heavy is it?
Well, I'll just hold the camera.
Yes.
And you can try it yourself.
This is a comparison of two telescopes, Schmidt Cassegrain telescopes. Both of them are Meade. One of them is a Meade LX90 ultra high contrast. I think this one is actually a 2004 model, and this one is a 2012 model. Meade LX90 ultra high contrast and advanced chroma free, and both of them are from the same company. This one is 2004 probably, this one is 2012. What's the difference between them is that I bought this from a company called ENS Optical in Birmingham. I paid around £950 for this. I paid it. They had to wait another 1 month for the person to contact me that they are going actually to give it to me. Then when I went to collect it, because they told that if you collect it, you'll get £50 discount. I went there on the telephone, everything. I was accused that I'm lying. I just want to come and see the thingy, and just they couldn't believe pretending. I went there and I saw that there are two telescopes. One, they told it's going to Serbia, and the telescope that was going to Serbia had a box, and this one, which was in this condition, the wrapped, had a wrapping on the lead cover. As you can see, it doesn't close properly, was the one that I paid in cash instantly, and I had to wait 1 month, be accused that I'm a liar, and just normal chat. I never had any problem. I never had any, just thought, I want to come take it, as they told that you come take £50 discount. And I thought that that was a little bit cheeky, because they actually hold my money for 1 month. Then I had to go and collect it again, and just, and anyway, it was not the best telescope. The wrapping was wrong. The lead was wrong. I bought a lot of accessories from them, but they didn't have any decency to give me a cap for the back, which comes with this telescope. So practically everything good went for the foreign customer of them, and the British customer didn't get. This is the one I bought from eBay. Paid £950 for this one, and I paid for this advanced camera free £520. And this is 8 years more modern, and you can see the difference. First of all, no problem with the lead, fits completely. This one the lid has a problem, it cannot fix. It has a wrap, never tights itself. Anyway, both of them are telescope. If you ask me, this one is a bit shorter than that one. Slightly, a few inches shorter. Anyway, what I noticed that this ENS optical, well, I was wondering where they get all these telescopes. They have second-hand telescopes everywhere, and they sell it. They have an eBay everywhere selling these things. I was wondering where they get it. And then gradually, after observing in eBay what they have on sale, it dawned on me that actually they buy the items from the eBay themselves. So this telescope probably was bought from somebody in the eBay, as I bought this one for myself from eBay. And they just resell it in the eBay. So this telescope, I have a LX200, similar to this, heavier, much better. I bought it £250. So I could buy this probably around £400. £400, £500. When this was actually £520. And now I'm understanding that they buy the things from the eBay. You can see that whatever they have is already appeared. If you follow the eBay for 2-3 months, you will see that the items that they buy from the eBay, they appear there. You see, for example, I saw a Dobsonian, homemade Dobsonian, somebody was selling for a long time, it was not sold, then he had reduced the price and somebody bought it, and that somebody was ENS Optical. And they have painted it, or they make appear in the eBay that they have painted it, or they have manipulated the image in the Photoshop. So it looks different color. The original color was brown, now it is appearing gray. They're just selling it. So I was wondering why I did like that, because I didn't know about these things. I didn't know that. I was really new to these all of things. And now I know that you can buy actually on eBay from people, honest people like ourselves, without actually having. And they didn't have the proper cap, didn't have the box. I had to spend £100 almost, for including delivery, for a bag for this. The box that I had actually went to Serbia. He sold it to them. And it doesn't have this back, so I have to put something to close this. Unlike this one, which I bought from an eBay customer, eBay seller, private. Gave me all the things coming with this. It has a comma-free optics. I have a video about this actually. You can see that when I was buying it, the guy actually was using a dirty cloth. It was a cloth for cleaning the glasses, but it was dirty. I could see it was full of dust. And he was not blowing the dust or anything, just rubbing it against it. And that's the reason you can see these markings there. Very unprofessional way. I was thinking by then that this guy is professional. He's a optical instrument maker and optician. He's not. He's just buying from eBay and selling them. He probably was obsessed with the telescopes like me, buying, then they realize he can do business with this. But anyway, you can buy it from eBay. Look at the beautiful coating on this. And the coating on this has been damaged completely. It doesn't have any coating yet. It seems, or very faint. And it's I'll show you what is this. It has ultra high transmission coating, or it has a label of it. I don't know, I don't trust anything anymore. It has a label which says ultra high transmission coating, and funny enough, on the rim of it, it says ultra high contrast, not ultra high transmission contrast or coating. So anyway, I don't know what to believe now. And this is 8 years newer, 520, 2004, 8 years older than this one, 2004, and 950, almost double the price, considering that I had to collect it and everything. So my recommendation is that you buy from your own honest sellers in eBay, not from resellers. They're nothing more than what you are actually yourself. And this is one of the earliest of the at Lenscombe 3. I was looking at the videos of a sky telescope in NIF, Northeast American Festival, Astronomy Festival, something like this in America. Dennis DeChico was talking with the Meade guys, and this was out before Meade was sold to the Chinese. And the telescope that was at Lenscombe 3, that was introduced in that year, and they had exactly the same arrangement. No marking here, no marking on that side, just at Lenscombe 3. It was the earliest batch that was going to be sold to the customers. So you can trace it back practically. This can be the lot of things. This Los Mandis, you had three little Los Mandis, one here, also one here. It has a counterweight also, and under it you can attach it. It had also another telescope, the Orion 880 millimeter gyroscope. It had here, it has this, of course, it has this finder. You can use that as a finder also. It came with a lot of accessories. The difference is that this one had this LNT level north technique for finding the direction. It broke practically, it was very flimsy. And this one actually has that attached here, again another good point. And I got everything for this, everything was original. As you can see, this is the way this one is. The lead even cannot be closed properly, and this one, everything perfect. So, a lesson here. Mechanically, both telescopes look the same to me. And then that here is a bit sharper, here is not that sharp. This one a little bit probably higher, slightly. The battery compartments are the same, and the handles are the same. Everything is the same. Optics and electronics are different. This is a advanced Comma 3. There's a GPS model. There's a GPS. It's not level north. There's a GPS, this one. That one is attached with a wire, goes that way, and it just makes it too awkward. This one has everything on it, the GPS version. It's the earliest model of the Advanced Comma 3, the original one, so everything was better, probably, in a way, you can say. And I got it for that good price. And I got the LX200, which is the daddy of all of this. I'm such a heavy thing, you can, you know, the optics is, I believe, is better than this. That one, 250, so really good sale, good chances to buy something. By the way, I forgot this one that I bought from the ENS Optical. The hand control of it was faulty. Even when they were in the video I've made, you can see the hand control is not working. The guy says, oh, it's not working. Maybe next time works, as if magic. He believes in magic. Anyway, I had to write. After 3 months, I think, communication, he finally sent me a replacement for that. For the faulty one, so practically. Yes, 3 months I paid, and 1 month I didn't have the telescope. We were just using my money, around £1,000, £950 with the petrol and everything I've collected. Then after that, 3 months I waited just to actually be able to use it with the thing, with the hand control. Not good experience. And this one, Advanced Comma 3 GPS version, LX90, came with a Autostar hand control. It talks, number one. Much better deal than that. Look at it. Wrapped. Look. Look at it. Come on. And we want to go out of EU with this kind of businesses and trades and manufacturings. I don't know, really. This is a customer service we get. I was thinking a long time why this ENS Optical guy was telling me that you are lying. When actually I paid money and I just wanted to come and collect it, as he told me that you can do it. And I was thinking why he was worried, why he was selling such a thing. It's just pointless. I didn't understand even what it means when he says we have fraudulent people lying. My money was in the bank account. 1 month passed. He was just every time saying, "I'm in Spain. I'm away." And now I realize that he may have some dealings with people, and he made a fraudulent treatment or something like that. Something went wrong, and the customer service was so bad. Somebody complained to somewhere important. And he was aware of that, and he was worried that somebody may come after him. He wanted to see him in his place. That's the only reason I can think of. Otherwise, what's the point of it? I paid the money. I just want my item. And my money was in his bank account. Direct debit, it went to his account. And I was wondering why £950 went to his bank account, and yet he was moaning about these things which I couldn't understand. I couldn't figure out what he's talking about. The money is in his hand. He has to deliver it. I think by then he was just trying to, because I saw a lot of things, I have a suspicion he may put parts, take one part from something, put it on another one, just makes them, you know, something like that. That's what I'm thinking. The box that was for mine went actually for somebody else, and the rubbish wrapped lead came for me again. None of this was mentioned when I was buying it from his website in a subtitle. So it's just all dodgy, looked dodgy, not right to me. I wish I didn't buy it, but then my money was in his hand, so I couldn't really. I was new also to eBay. I didn't know that you can buy it actually in eBay. You just have to wait for the right item to arrive. Anyway, it was a compulsive buy. Right?